Greetings, welcome to a video on how to install R in RStudio. We're going to be using RStudio this semester for all of our explorations into the world of statistics. RStudio is the interface in which we use to use R, which is our computational engine, so to speak. It is the thing that actually does the calculations. So we're going to figure out how to download and install both these software packages, and then we're going to take a few minutes to configure RStudio to get it to do what we want it to do. So let's start off with downloading R. That's our first job. So go to our favorite browser, or whatever browser you particularly care for, and we're going to go to where they store R. So that's at www.r-project.org. Okay, and so hit an enter, and that's going to take us to the R website. And what you want to do now is click on the Download R button right there. Now it takes us to a variety of different places in the world we can go to download it. The first one is just fine, so we'll click on that one. And then we'll pick what flavor of computer that we have. Now I have a Mac, so I'll select on Mac, but of course if you have Windows, you click on Windows. Or if you're an Uber geek, you click on Linux. Now on the Mac, you have a choice of two different packages you can download, one for a more modern Mac like Mavericks or Yosemite. Or if you have an older Mac, then you want to come down here and you want to select Snow Leopard. Now, these numbers are constantly changing. R is always being updated. So if you're watching this in the future sometime, the numbers might be different here, but the idea is the same. Now, if you're in Windows, you want to go for the basic. You're going to go download the base package. Don't go for any of the fancy stuff. Just the very first one that shows up there will work. Okay, since I'm on the Mac, I'll grab that one and we'll wait for this to download. It'll take just a minute or so. And then once it gets downloaded, we'll open it up and actually run the package on a Mac. And Windows is going to download an exe, and you're going to go ahead and execute that exe and just follow through what it tells you to do. Go with the defaults on each of them and you'll be just fine, good to go. Okay, so go ahead and open up the package on a Mac, say continue, I agree. Go ahead and install, say yes, I am Mike Butler and I want you to do this. Okay, put in my password, do the install, and now it's going to go ahead and install R. Now again, this is the engine of our car, so to speak. It's not where we're going to actually go to drive things. It's the thing that makes things move. It's the computational engine. So once we get this installed, we have to install yet another package and configure that. That's the front end. That's RStudio. That's where we actually do our communication with R and get it to actually produce the graphs and the numbers and other things that we would like it to do. Okay, so once my thermometer gets all the way over there to the right, voila, we are done. We close. And that's all we need to do with R proper. We're not going to actually run the software. We can, but we're not going to run it that way. We're always going to use RStudio to interact with R. So now this time we want to go to RStudio. That's www.rstudio.com. And when we go there, we're going to get some different choices. The very first thing we're going to do is click on Download RStudio. And scroll down a bit and click on Desktop. And then scroll down a bit and you want to go to the free version, not the $995 version. Now you're going to get your choice of flavors again. So on the Mac version, we'll go with this one. And if Windows, of course, you would go with that one. So again, we have to wait for this to come down, like just a minute. What we're going to do after we get this downloaded, we're actually going to run RStudio and we're going to go in and configure it to turn it into more or less what, for our purposes, is going to be a scientific word processor. Okay, so this is a DMG on a Mac, so open up this DMG, which is a disk image. And then on a Mac, we're just going to take this blue marble right here, and we'll drag it over onto Applications. Since I've already installed it already, it's going to ask me if I want to replace. You probably won't see that, don't worry about that. And voila, it is finished. Okay, so now we've got that installed. So now what we need to do is we need to actually run RStudio and get it to do what we want to do. So in on the Mac, that means I need to go to the Finder and go to Applications. If you're on a Windows machine, you need to go to your Programs menu, and you'll find a folder in your Programs menu that says RStudio. On the Mac, you go into Applications, and you'll find an icon that says RStudio on it. Now, what you want to do is you want to take that, whether you're on a Mac or Windows, and you want to drag that down to your taskbar or your dock on a Mac. You want to put that down on there so that you've got ready access to that. That is the one you're going to use, okay? We're not going to interact directly with R. So when you go to find the software, make sure you see this blue marble with the R on it, not an R with a C behind it. That's not the way we want to do it, okay? All right, so once you've got it installed and you've got your shortcut set there, you're ready to go. Go ahead and fire off R. Verifying it, yes, I know I downloaded it from the interweb. It's okay to go ahead and run that thing. Okay, and voila, there we go. We got it running, okay? So yours should look somewhat similar to mine. Might look slightly different depending on your computer. You have basically three windows here, or three panes within the window. There's the console, that's where you interact with R. There's the place where we see the history of our commands and where data gets stored, that's up here in environment. And then down here, this pane, this is all of the place where we see the files, the plots, packages, etc. We're going to go into a lot more detail about what all these panes are about, and another pane that's going to show up here in just a minute, which is our editor, in another video. But for now, we just want to get some basic configurations done on RStudio here. So how do we do that? Well, we need to go in, first of all, and tell RStudio where we want to store our files. So if you click on Tools, and you go down to Global Options, get a window that looks like this. And the first item in the window is General, and what we want to do is set up a place to go and store our R files, okay? So now if you're on a Mac, I want you to go back to the Finder for just a minute. And I need you to go over to your Documents folder and then create a folder called R files. So you should know how to do that, to create a folder, and that's going to be where you're going to keep your stuff, okay? Now if you're in a Windows machine, go into your libraries, go into Documents, go into My Documents, and same thing, make a folder called R files, all right? So once you've done that, I'll give you a second here, go ahead and do that. You can pause the video if you need to. Then come on back and we're going to actually make the working directory where we want it, okay? So come back over to here to the window we opened up and click on Browse. When we go to Browse, we'll go to Documents. And from there, I'm going to scroll down until I see my R files, and I will say open. And when I do that, notice now the path should read the same as mine. It should say documents or my documents, or if you're in a Windows machine, and then R files. And so what that does is it gives us a place, the default place it's going to put all of our work. It's going to make our lives a lot easier. So we'll click apply on that, then we'll click OK. And if you come over here and click on files, you should now see across these breadcrumbs right here, it should say Home, Documents, and R Files. It'll be slightly different on a Windows machine. You might see Documents and My Documents and R Files, but this is the path by which it tells you that you're going to get to your files, okay? All right, cool. Now, let's go ahead and create a document. Let's go make a sample document here. Oh, time out, wait, sorry, my head, getting ahead of myself. We gotta put some packages in first. We gotta put some augmentations onto R. So click on the Packages tab down here for me, please. And then once you've done that, click on Install. And the first package that we're going to want to put in here is we're going to put in a package called Knitter. So I'm going to type K-N-I-T-R. You can see it's already auto-completing for me down below there. And then click on Install. Takes a minute or so. You'll see some action going on here over in the console here any minute now. There we go. And it's going to go ahead and install the Knitter package. Now, one thing you may notice that I'm moving at a fair clip here. I got a lot of stuff to cover in a short video, so it's okay to watch this thing all the way through and then come back and watch it again to see exactly what I did and where I did it, okay? If you watch it twice, sometimes it makes it a little easier. Okay, so click on Install one more time, because actually we're going to do this total of three times because we have three packages we want to install. And we're going to install Open Intro, which is intro. There we go. See, if you can't spell like me, you can just grab the one down below there. Make your life easy, okay? Open intro. This is a textbook package. Came with the textbook that we'll be using. Has some data sets in it that are nice. There are data sets in here that were used to produce the graphics in our textbook. And there'll be occasion where we'll want to have access to those for problem sets and other things. Okay, one last one. And that's, again, to put more data in, more data sets that we can use to do our little exploring into the world of stats. And it's going to be OI for open intro data. See, this is the first one that came up there. That was a capital O and a capital I, by the way. It is case sensitive. You got to use that. And so click install on that. And boom, we're done. Okay, so that's all the packages that we're going to need for the time being, probably for most of the semester. And now what we're going to do is go take this thing for a test drive and see if actually that first package we put in Knitter, whether it works or not. So if you go to this button up here, that's where you make a new document. So we're going to click on that. And our studio allows us to create all sorts of different types of documents within it. The one we're going to predominantly be using is an R markdown file. So go ahead and click on R markdown for me. And you're going to get this window where it asks you to give the title of the file. Let's call this test for a test file. And then down here, the author puts your name in there. And notice you have the options of your default output from a Knitter file to be HTML, a PDF, or a Microsoft Word document. So for our class, we're going to use HTML. So we want to make sure you highlight that one if it's not already. Most of that is the default, so you should be fine. So click on OK. And you notice we get a brand new window opened up. This is our editor pane or our editor window. And notice it's telling us it's an R markdown file and it's giving us this sample file. So what we're going to want to do is actually knit or turn this sample file into HTML. But before we do that, we're going to go ahead and save it. So come back over here into the lower right pane and click on files for me again. And then come back over here into the editor pane and click on the save current document for me. So once you do that, there we go, you notice that you should, see right here, it should have defaulted right into the R files. That's the place where things go, okay? Now, you want to get in the habit every time you create a new document or a new assignment of storing that in its own folder. So we're going to make a new folder first, a subfolder within our R files. This is just good file management, and we'll call this test file, okay? Go ahead and create that. And then up here under on Untitled, we're just going to call that test, okay? We'll go ahead and save. And we notice two things. We notice that the name now shows up here, test RMD. That's for R markdown. And we notice we have a new folder now that shows up in our R files, which is where test file is. If you go and click on that, you see, by Jove, there it is, right? You can go back up a directory by either clicking on the breadcrumbs or clicking on the arrow here to go up a directory to go back up if you'd like. Okay, well, that was all well and good. We're doing pretty good here. Actually, I do want to actually keep that file folder open so you can see what happens here. And I'm now going to go ahead and knit it. So to knit it, all I have to do is just click on knit HTML. Notice a new window open down on the console that's an R markdown folder. It's telling us what's going on. And bada bing, bada boom, you should have got a preview of what your file did, okay? So we'll explain a lot more about the code that is in that editor and what it actually did in further videos. But this is just a check to make sure that things are working. You should see text intermixed with summary data intermixed with graphs, which is kind of what we want to have. We want to have this ability to easily type up our homework and actually include the graphics in there. Okay, so the nice thing is that this particular file is now available to be turned in as homework. So let me show you how you do that real quick, and then we'll call it good in this video. So let's go back to our browser, and I need you to navigate to our course site, to Math 15, section V8400. Now, it looks a little sparse at the moment because I'm not finished putting this all together, but I need to show you this one part so you can see what's going on here. I want to click on modules because that's where I go to find my assignments. When I click on modules, I'll see test knitter file as one of my assignments in module 0, which was, once this video is done, it'll be in here too. It's going to look different than what you actually are seeing once the course is started. So I click on that assignment. And let me go ahead and expand my window here a bit so we can see everything that's in here. Oh, wait, I'm sorry, I've got to back up just a minute here. I got it in the wrong view. You guys are seeing my view. Sorry about that. I need to go make myself a student first. So there we go. Go to student view. Now we'll go back to modules. Now we'll go to our knitter file. And what we see is a submission button. Now, I've already tested this to make sure it works, so you'll see what this is what happens when you've actually done the submission. Before you do it, you'll have a button here that says, you know, submit a file, okay? So I'll go ahead and resubmit it just so you can see how it works. Come over here, go to choose file. Go to my test file, and I want to upload not the RMD, I want to upload the HTML. All the files that we're going to be turning in this semester, for the most part, some exceptions, are going to be HTML files. So I click on that, and then I submit the assignment. And of course, you could put some comments in there like, oh, this was the best assignment ever, I loved it, can't wait to do more of this. This just rocked, okay? And it says it successfully did it. Now, Canvas is set up that right now it only will accept into these assignments where it's expecting a knitter file, an HTML file, it only will accept an HTML, okay? So make sure that you get those put in correctly. Okay, well, that was a lot to digest rather quickly. Please feel free to watch this as many times as you need. And of course, there is always the option of sending me questions, or better yet, posting questions in the discussion area having to do with this module to help you out with any problems that you're having. I'll try to get back to you very quickly.